To plan Disneyland, Walt Disney long ago established a design organization called WED Enterprises. Today, the staff at WED includes designers, architects, and engineers skilled in the Disney way, and also fine craftsmen and technicians skilled in the arts of the space age. What WED does is called Imagineering, the blending of creative imagination with technical know-how. The talents of WED have gone to work outside Disneyland, too. In his keynote speech before the 1963 Urban Design Conference at Harvard University, Mr. Rouse said in part, quote, "I hold a view that may be somewhat shocking to an audience as sophisticated as this, that the greatest piece of urban design in the United States today is Disneyland. If you think about Disneyland and think of its performance in relation to its purpose, its meaning to people, more than that, its meaning to the process of development, you will find it the outstanding piece of urban design in the United States. It took an area of activity, the amusement park, and lifted it to a standard so high in its performance, in its respect for people, in its functioning for people, that it really has become a brand new thing. It fulfills all the functions it set out to accomplish, unselfconsciously, usefully, and profitably to its owners and developers. I find more to learn in the standards that have been set and in the goals that have been achieved in the development of Disneyland than in any other single piece of physical development in the country." End quote. Yesterday, Disneyland and the New York World's Fair. Tomorrow, a project so vast it has already been called a whole new Disney World. And now, here is Walt Disney.
Welcome to a little bit of Florida here in California. This is where the early planning is taking place for our so-called Disney World project. Now, the purpose of this film is to bring you up to date about some of the plans for Disney World. But the most exciting, by far the most important part of our Florida project, in fact, the heart of everything we'll be doing in Disney World, will be our experimental prototype city of tomorrow. We call it Epcot, spelled E-T-C-O-T, Experimental Prototype Community of Tomorrow. Here it is in larger scale. Epcot will take its cue from the new ideas and new technologies that are now emerging from the creative centers of American industry. It will be a community of tomorrow.
Epcot will be a working community with employment for all. And everyone who lives here will have a responsibility to help keep this community an exciting, living blueprint of the future. And now here again is Walt Disney.
That's the starting point for our experimental prototype community of tomorrow. And now, where do we go from these preliminary plans and sketches? Well, a project like this is so vast in scope that no one company alone can make it a reality. But if we can bring together the technical know-how of American industry and the creative imagination of the Disney organization, I'm confident we can create right here in Disney World a showcase to the world of the American free enterprise system. We think the need is for starting from scratch on virgin land and building a special kind of new community. So that's what Epcot is, an experimental prototype community.
First, the area of business and commerce. Next, the high-density apartment housing. And a wide range of office buildings, some containing services required by Epcot's residents, but most of them designed especially to suit the local and regional needs of major corporations. But most important, this entire 50 acres of city streets and buildings will be completely enclosed. In this climate-controlled environment...
Can you tell me what's happening here?
Well, my sources are no longer fully annotated and my information is somewhat anecdotal. But I believe what was once one race want to. One above, and one below. Two distinct species that have evolved.
And how do those below survive?
That is the real question, is it?
Do you know anything about birth credits? The 21 years and carbon tax that you pay to get a license to have a baby, does that have anything to do with Agenda 21? And if so, that's frightening.
Well, I haven't heard of that, and I think it, you know, I mean, it sounds, you know, I'm going to say that it sounds like somebody's idea of a great idea, but I don't think that's happening now. I know in China, of course, they will abort you forcibly at 9 months if you haven't paid your fee to have your second kid. But I haven't heard, you know, of what I would say, though, is that this is where it's headed, okay? And I'm not going to go to a science fiction thing, but what I'm saying is that it is headed that way because if you commoditize carbon, then we are made of carbon. And your life is about exhaling CO2. And if we're talking about family production credits, and whether you are a producing member of society or a consuming member of society, which is the way that this is viewed, then yes, if you are old or if you are a child, you are not producing, you're consuming. And it's very, you know, I mean, you could see that happening in the future, but I don't see anything like that at this time.
Request to leave the United States. Granted. Proceed.
I'm a guest. Yours is the little one, hers is the rest. Am I right or am I right? Never known it to fail. Why they gotta change clothes 3 times in a single day? I'll never.
Got a positive here.
Oh no, it's gotta be Miss Jensen.
Goddamn breeders. Excuse my language, ma'am. You'd think they'd learn.
Some never do.
Ain't that the truth?
Next.
Your turn.
Don't want to leave her favorite dress behind.
Thanks.
Man, I'm just so tired, you know, been driving all night and...
Hey, she's trying to get past our machines. She's got a fucking black jacket.
Tubes.
They said they did. Guess we got lucky.
This ain't lucky. What'd they give you?
31 years.
You're smiling. How the fuck can you be smiling?
She got away.
You are about to enter a complete security environment. Crime does not pay.
This place is supposed to be gigantic. Where the fuck is it?
Hey, calm down. Take a deep breath.
Forget him. He's dead.
He's just scared, okay?
Scared don't survive inside.
Prison Director Poe. The federal government pays Mentel $27 every day for each one of them. They expect us to put you to use expanding our facility.
Hidden weaponry.
Open your mouth, now!
The fortress is alive 24 hours a day.
Take it out of your mouth, put it in the bay.
Your work shift will be determined by our computer Z10. You will learn to live without day or night. These are psychological security intelligence systems. P-S-I-N.
Now!
Your thoughts will be with me always.
So touchy. I suppose that's understandable.
Still, you would not want to lose this particular former soldier, would you? Before she reached the far side of the bridge. The law is clear. One child per woman. We live on a very small and fragile planet. We must maintain the population balance. Abortion is illegal, and that leaves only one alternative.
I just want to hold my baby for a little while. I know I can't keep her, but just to see her open her eyes. I'm not gonna let them take my baby.
Remove number 74270.
Oh, no.
Thank you.
Right, kids, just before you go, there's a brilliant idea in the air that I'd like to run by you. Now, it's called 10-10. The idea is everyone starts cutting their carbon emissions by 10%, thus keeping the planet safe for everyone, eventually. Now, this hasn't got to be a huge thing, but I would love it if you and your families would think about doing something.
What sort of thing, miss?
Well, like getting your dad to insulate the loft, or taking your next holiday by train instead of flying, or buying energy-saving light bulbs.
We're thinking of using our car lift. I'm going to cycle to school.
That's fantastic, Jemima. Now, no pressure at all, but it'd be great to get a sense of how many of you might do this. Just a rough percentage. That's fantastic! And there's Noah. Philip and Tracy. That's fine, that's absolutely fine. Your own choice. Okay, class, thank you so much for today, and I will see you all tomorrow. Oh! Just before you go, I just need to press this little button. Everybody, please remember to read chapters 5 and 6 on volcanoes and glaciations. Except for Philip and Tracy, of course.
Right, just want to check on that 10-10 thing. Had some brilliant ideas from lots of you, how the firm can cut down emissions by 10%. Just a quick show of hands, everyone who wants to get involved. Great, that's nearly everybody. And, just for the record, new pressure. Those who aren't quite convinced about it yet. Cool, no problem. Your choice. Okay, so those of you planning something here or at home should probably get working on it. Oh, gorgeous. Those of you who aren't... Excellent. Have a great weekend, everyone.
Well, hello everyone. It's great to be back here at Spurs. So many happy memories for me. Anyway, tell me something. What is this 10-10 thing the club is doing?
Well, it means that we're trying to cut our carbon emissions by 10% this year. And Tottenham Hotspur Football Club was the first to sign up.
We've changed the floodlights on our lane, so no low energy.
Lots of our fans are coming to matches on buses, trains, bikes and stuff, rather than coming by car.
I see. Whatever, I wouldn't do it. It seems like distraction from football to me.
That's just fine, David. You don't have to join in. Just ignore it. No pressure. Right, lads. Let's do some penalties.
10-10. Hundreds of thousands of people, schools, businesses, hospitals, movie stars, knitting circles, scout troops, presidents and governments, all tackling climate change in more than 40 countries. Care to join us? No pressure.
Is that okay?
Sounded great to me. Thanks,
okay.
Julian.
Happy to help.
So what are you thinking of doing for 10-10 yourself?
What, are you kidding me? I thought that by doing this voiceover, that was my contribution.
Right. No, absolutely. No pressure.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Chandrala, what's going on? Chandrala, the cryptic writer extraordinaire.